to the Al Janoub Stadium in Al Wakrah in Qatar. Group B, match day 3 of the AFC Asian Cup Qatar 2023. Australia versus Uzbekistan. Perfect conditions as normal. Situation where Australia are top of the group and already qualified. But are they going to do it as group winners or runners-up? Uzbekistan, there's a chance they could drop down to P3 if things go against them. Syria versus India going on at the same time. FIFA ranked number 25 in the world. Australia already through to the round of 16, bracing for tougher tasks in the competition. Beautiful conditions here today, 25 degrees centigrade, but this pitch is largely in shade. If Australia were to win at a stadium where they enjoyed double success in the FIFA World Cup 15 months ago, then they'll top the group in the Asian Cup Finals for the first time since 2011. And it would also be the first time they've won all three group matches in the Asian Cup. To progress here and in this edition, they simply need to avoid defeat against the world number 68, Uzbekistan, a team who haven't scored a goal against the Socceroos in four previous matches, one of which was a 2019 round of 16 match where Uzbekistan lost their nerve in a 4-2 penalty shootout loss. Three Aussies and four Uzbeks who played in that game are in the nation's respective squads today. And Des Corkill alongside me in the commentary box to describe the game for you at the Al Janoub Stadium is Paul Masefield. And Paul, it's a strange one in many ways from Australia. Are they satisfied with going for a point, or do they try to get three wins out of three for the first time ever?
Well, he's tried to get a few players in to give them a little bit of game time because they've qualified already, but realistically, I would think they would like to go through and go into it having won all three games. We spoke to Bejic a little bit earlier on, and that's what he said. He said the aim was to top the group, the aim was to win all three group games. Then it sends a message to the other teams that are in this Asian Cup that they are serious, they're here, and they are here to be here all the way through to the final.
You could say the same for Uzbekistan as well in some ways. They've tinkered with the lineup. They've gone to a back three, we believe, once again. If they win, though, they top the group, and it's potentially an easier, in inverted commas, easier route into the latter stages.
Yeah, just for that round of 16, but then things do start to toughen up when you get to the 8 best teams in Asia at the quarterfinals. So you would want to top the group. I think you would be daft. Any coach would be daft if they turned around and said they wanted to finish in second place. You want to win all your matches, you want to do it comfortably, you don't want yellow cards, you don't want injuries, you don't want suspensions. So if you can get through this group phase with all that intact and top that group, it does and it should hold you in good stead.
This is the Asian Cup Qatar 2023. It is the third of the group matches. Uzbekistan in the blue versus the green and gold of Australia. A place in the round of 16 beckons for both. Potential problems for Uzbekistan if Syria score a hatful and they go behind Uzbekistan. We'll keep an eye on that game as it goes on. It's being played simultaneously, Syria versus India. But our focus is very much on events here at the Al Janoub Stadium. It's Australia versus Uzbekistan. We'll give you the official team news after the respective national anthems of the countries.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise if you are able for the national anthem of Australia.
أصحاب السموم والسعادة السيدات والسادة يرجى التكرم بالوقوف في حال القدرة لعزف النشيد الوطني لأستراليا.
Please remain standing for the national anthem of Uzbekistan.
والآن يرجى تكرم بالوقوف لعزف النشيد الوطني لأوزبكستان.
Being waved, rousing renditions of the respective national anthems. Opportunity beckons for Uzbekistan, who've got a really good record of progression into the knockout stage of the AFC Asian Cup. They'll be looking to make it six in a row to the knockout stages. Selection for Graham Arnold. Five changes for him in his 65th match overall in charge of Australia. 49 in this, his second spell as national coach. Defensively, Harter Midlothian duo Kai Rowles and Nathalian Atkinson come in at right-back and centre-back. Keanu Backhurst restored to the midfield with Middlesbrough's Riley McGree getting his first start of the Asian Cup. And up front, a fourth cap for Big Yazuna Yenge in place of the injured Mitch Duke, who'll lead the line. Not many goals on the bench for Australia. Only Craig Goodwin, with two, has registered for the Socceroos on the international stage. Match referee Yuzuki Araki from Japan, 37-year-old, was involved in the FIFA Under-20 World Cup in Argentina earlier on this year. Been recently officiating in the Indonesian League as well. Video match officials from China and Japan, Junpei Ida and Fuming, in charge of the VAR. They've been quite busy in this tournament. Graham Arnold and Cheko Katanek, two very experienced coaches, shaking hands. Four changes from Katanek, the Slovenian. Yusupov keeps his place in goal, but defensively, Zafarmurad, Abdi Rakhmatov and Abdullah Abdullah get their first start. Rustam Ashurmatov is returned to the back five, having missed the game versus India. Shukarov and Khamrebekov are the heart of midfield, while Fayzuliev is ostensibly a left-sided midfielder, but expect the 20-year-old to get up in support of the front two of Erkinov, restored to the first 11, having missed the win over India, and Oslan Urinov. Attacking options on the bench include Igor Sergeyev and Azizbek Amanov, should they be required. Paul Masefield, do you expect Uzbekistan to require attacking options later on in the contest?
Possibly, but I think that they've set up definitely to get themselves a point to ensure that they do finish in that top two. It was interesting talking to Katanec before the game. He turned around and said, look, I don't care if we win, I don't care if we draw. All I want is my players to leave everything out on the pitch. So I think that's why he's gone with a back five, just a little bit of caution to start with. They can change formation, they can be a little bit more expansive if they want, depending on whether or not they need to shore things up. So I think he's got it spot on today to take on this Australia side.
Up front, a lot of responsibility lying on Fayzuliev to give Urinov and Erkinov opportunities to make it through. But we are seconds away from the game. Match day three of the group stage, Australia in the green and gold versus Uzbekistan. Australia going left to right. They are top of the group with two wins out of two and six matches since they last conceded a goal. And that was in a 1-0 defeat against England. They are a very resilient and solid team. Graham Arnold is really trying to give one or two key players a little bit of rest.
Vitally important as well. And again, we mentioned about you don't want those injuries, you don't want niggles, you don't want suspensions. But also you want to have your best players in top form when you're going into those knockout stage games, which will be coming soon.
Yangi just beaten to the punch there, and this will break out now. Urunov, the winger who has been asked to play centrally in the opening game against Syria, and he really struggled a little bit. Looked a lot more comfortable when he played out wide, as you're seeing there, under pressure. And he nearly smuggled the ball through to Otabek Shukarov. First touch for Matty Ryan, 89th cap for Matty Ryan. You have a theory about the mask with Matty Ryan, don't you? You think it might be a little bit distracting, the fact he has to wear it.
It could be, but once you get comfortable with it, once you get used to it, just wonder if he uses the same one in training so that he does become used to it and gets that feel to his face. Can be off-putting at times, though.
He did have a scary moment in the 1-0 win over Syria where a routine shot was almost spilled into his net. He recovered. Suta. Uzbekistan setting up a 5-4-1 and they're facing the ball, and that's Abdirakhmatov, the Nassaf wing-back, winning his third cap, just 20 years of age. A couple of good young players. They do have a really good development, Uzbekistan. They routinely make it to the final stages in AFC age competitions. Yeah, Fazuliyev is particularly good up front.
There's been some vast investment there, shall we say that, where money's been put in at grassroots level, and it's also fed up the system as well, which is why they're producing such good players.
Martin Boyle. Slid in, Ashurmatov can clear. Shukarov. We ran into trouble, Shukarov. And Jackson Irvin nearly got a deflection through there to Kuzini Yengi.
Yeah, it's tight though, isn't it? You can see they are playing that five and the wing-backs are tucking in. So it is going to be difficult for this Australian side to break it down. They are going to have to look to break through the lines, try and get in behind as well, get some crosses in. That's where they'll get joy today.
We've had a look at both coaches on the bench. Both are very, very experienced. Graham Arnold in his second spell as Aussie coach. Katanech has coached Slovenia a couple of times, UAE, Iraq, as Yangi chases forward. And here in Uzbekistan, this is his 31st game in charge. Just 60 feet in those 30 previous games for Katanech. He's a wily campaigner.
Got to have that experience as well. That's why it's important that you do have senior players in your team as well as the younger players. Just need that fine balance of youth, experience and exuberance, really.
Yusupov, the Navbohor goalkeeper, going long. Fazuliyev isn't going to win many in the air against Kai Rolls and Harry Suter.
You're right there.
Chasing down, tries to keep it alive and successfully does so. That's Riley McGree, and he's done well, McGree.
Just that last touch, wasn't it? Not happy about something on the halfway line.
Yeah, there's a man down. Katanech isn't concerned about Ashurmatov, who was caught. Ashurmatov caught his own man, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He did catch him as well, right on the top of the head. But as you said, Katanech going absolutely ballistic at one of his players on the pitch there. Didn't want them in a certain position, wanting them to tuck around a little bit more.
Well, it's Safayev who was out on the left-hand side and McGree was able to cut in. So that clash of heads. And this is taking quite a while for Farouk Safayev.
Yeah, it was a flailing arm that caught him. Ashurmatov's arm just catching him right on the... Well, you can see there, right on the forehead.
Thanks, pal. You're meant to be on my side.
Listen, if the ball's there to be won, even if it's your teammate, you have to go and win the ball.
Uzbekistan temporarily down to 10 men. Yangi the target. Ooh, looked like a little push in the back there on Jackson Irvin. White Wolves struggling to get the ball clear, and that's high up in the air from Eshmuradov. Finds Boyle. Eshmuradov and Shermatov eventually smuggling it out. Played out to Urunov. Labahor winger's gone a long, long way. Harry Suter steps in, but he's gone the full length of the pitch there.
Great run, just to take a little bit of pressure off as well. Just kept going, didn't he?
Riley McGree. We're told Australia like to play a 4-3-3, but I think everyone's expecting McGree to get forward an awful lot more from the right-hand side of the midfield.
Yeah, they are. You can see quite clearly that Backus is just sitting in front of that back line. It's almost like a 4-1-4-1, as it were. That's what they're transitioning into. They allow McGree and Irving to get further forwards and get beyond the strikers.
Lovely ball around the shoulder. Boyle's cross. Yenge didn't really seem to drive into that. It breaks to Jackson Irving. Little give and go. Irving pulls it back. Yenge beating it in the air. Urunov just helps it clear.
Promising there from the Australians. Great ball in. Great work from Boyle getting to that byline and just hanging it up at the far post. I was like you. I thought Yenge was going to absolutely bury that, but just got caught a little bit flat-footed, I think.
He's just eased off the ball by Eshmuradov. Plays in a physical league in England for Portsmouth. Had a very good season, as had Pompey. Fazuliev can't control. Total dominance of the ball in this opening 8 minutes by Australia. Bajic. Suter. Oh, he's giving it away, and Urunov is through. Urunov has got support. Fazuliev in the middle. Urunov miscontrols, and Suter recovers.
I think Urunov should have looked up and should have hit that first time. Matty Ryan was miles outside his goal.
A little bit indecisive, Urunov there. Also, Australia guilty of giving the ball away. Bajic goes out to cover Abdelrahmatov. Nicely worked out, McGree. Again, given away, Backus. And Jackson Irving eventually sorted out. Irving's got a couple of important goals for Australia. I'm sure in years to come there'll be 30-yard humdingers, but scrappy though they may both have been. Very, very valuable for Australia's campaign so far.
Doesn't matter, you've just got to put the ball in the back of the net. Doesn't matter if it comes off your ear, it's still a goal. That's what it gets chalked up as.
Bajic rolls. When Australia have possession, Uzbekistan happy to kind of let the Aussies, or the Socceroos, have it there. Yenge made a forward run. He's now in an offside position. Shukarov with the touch. Bajic, a miscontrol. India versus Syria is the other match in this group. That is being played simultaneously. 0-0 at the moment. Bajic gets the cross in, must break to Yenge! Flag is up for offside. Now, whether or not Yenge could have let that one cross the line, the angle might tell us, and VAR will have a look. Your thoughts, Paul Masefield?
It's going to be an interesting one. It's going to be very, very close. Is he offside when the ball is played in? Now, quite clearly, he's ahead. And you can see he's gone for the ball, gone to flick it, Boyle, so there's no question about that. Clear cut. Not a tough decision, that one, for the referee or VAR. Who get it spot on?
That young fella didn't agree. But that was one of the easier VAR decisions, I suspect, although it is still being checked.
It shouldn't take them too long. We have seen a few VAR checks that have taken time where it's needed that time to make that correct decision. As the officials check this one, though, I'm sure we'll restart pretty quickly.
Cross did go forward. The cross didn't come back, did it? Yeah, OK. Goal is chalked off. Yenge, who's yet to open his international account, is still yet to open his international account. But it was encouraging for Australia that he was actually in and around the six-yard box looking to finish things off.
Oh, it's important. You want your goal scorers sniffing in and around there.
Boyle eased off the ball. Safayev gladly recovered from that smack to the bridge of the nose.
A little bit physical here, wasn't he? The arm up and stepping across him. Safayev just saying, you're not going past me. Dangerous position again, because when you've got the likes of Suter and Rawls there, that are big, big boys coming up from the back, they can get on the end of things.
Harry Suter's got 10 international goals to his name.
I bet they're all from set plays. He is a big lad.
He's right in the middle. Angled in, but too much. That's disappointing. And Yusupov wasn't required to come and collect that one from Riley McGree.
That was a poor ball in from him. Completely overcooked it on that occasion.
Fazuliev. Exciting young talent. Plays his football for CSKA Moscow. Pavlobikov, the heart of the midfield. His 49th international cap, Pavlobikov. Here he is once again. It's just in front of the back three. It allows Shukarov, the captain, to maybe stride forward a little bit more. Safayev. Ashurmatov, another who plays his football in Russia. Abdulayev.
Good shape, that, from Australia, forcing Uzbekistan to play it around in front of them. But at the same time, it's giving Uzbekistan now a little bit more confidence in this game. They were trailing when it came to the possession stats, so keeping the ball for a few minutes will do them the world of good.
That's loose. Ashurmatov had to stretch. He's done well to find Safayev. Little give and go. Suter. Eased on by Bakus. Ashurmatov wins it back for Shukarov. Urunov. Suter. Bajic, his 67th cap today, as is Bajic. That's given away by Keanu Bakus. Won it back offside against Yenge.
Okay, it was. There's no question about that. May not agree with it, but it was clearly a yard offside.
Andrei Rakhmatov. Lot of Scottish League players in the Australian lineup, a lot of Uzbek League players in the Uzbek lineup. Both are relatively physical leagues. Ando Rakhmatov plays for the Nassaf club, to the champion club Paktakor. Lovely little give and go, pull back, rolls as well just to guard that 6 yard line.
And just killing the box. See the cutback there. Sometimes when you do get that close to the byline, you just need to hang one up at the far post. Did have that option.
Flag is up for offside there against Erkanov, who's had a very quiet start, the Paktakor winger. And he's another young talent. Graham Arnold and Rennie Mullenstein mulling over what Australia have done well in this first 15 minutes.
Yeah, kept the ball, that's the important thing, and they've looked livelier, they've created the better opportunities. But Uzbekistan haven't looked bad either. Their shape's been tight, it's been solid. We knew they were going to do that when they were playing the five at the back. And they've hit on the counter-attack on a couple of occasions and could have caused an issue or two. So a nice open game of football this is.
Shermatov was being closed down, moved that well, and Shukarov, who plays his football in Turkey, just helped it onto Saifiev, who can play either of these wing-back roles or either right-back or left-back. Very useful versatility to have in your squad. Abdullayev fizzed in. Just can't be kept in by Abdurakhmatov. Erkanov was given a heck of a ball to try and control.
Nice little move, though, again, from Uzbekistan, the way that they're moving the ball.
Ryan eases it out. Matt Atkinson. Australia got fond memories of this stadium from the FIFA World Cup. Possession nearly 70-30 for Australia.
Keeping their shape, that's the big thing. In fact, both sides are, just for that one little mistake from Suter. A little error could cost you. Didn't on that occasion, though.
A draw guarantees both team a place in the next round. Australia already there, but Australia would go through as group winners. Uzbekistan has runners-up. Then the calculations of the permutation start for the round of 16. We won't go there, not yet. McGree. Irvin. Just a little bit behind Jordan Boss. Bejic. Trying to slide Bejic in for the 1-2, Riley McGree. Up forward. Shmuradov hacks it clear. Suter picked out by Shermatov. Urunov once again. Chance to run at Suter. Fazuliev in the middle. Slows it down. Shukarov. Saifiev. Decent ball from Saifiev. Erkanov coming in at the back post. Good physicality from Abdurakhmatov.
Good play, I think, from Uzbekistan. You could see when they won it back, they broke very, very quickly. Urunov peeling into that wide area, stretching that Australian defence, who, at the end, were at full stretch.
Now Shermatov, angle ball for Erkanov. Nice take.
Lovely take. What a touch. He's just killed it dead, hasn't he? Brilliant touch.
He was really exciting in the first half against Syria when he was allowed to run at his fullback. Urunov tried to turn Atkinson into circles. Shukarov. Shukarov once again. I resisted mentioning Eldor Shomorodov for 20 minutes, Paul. But his absence, his loss, you can't not look at Uzbekistan and think that they are missing somebody like him up front.
No, I know. It is a big blow, but at the end of the day, that gives another player an opportunity, a chance. And you've said that they've got a couple of good youngsters here. So it's their time to step up and shine. But he is sorely missed, there's no doubt about that.
Fazuliev will try to get along the back. He is the replacement, Fazuliev. Fazuliev, good blocking. Bajic wants the flag to go up, but he didn't. Kyrgios needed to make that block. Saifayev, a little bit behind Urunov, who looks so much happier, given the chance to play wide. He's taking on Atkinson at every opportunity. Abdur Akhmatov, little give and go onto Erkinov. Two youngsters combining. Abdullayev, all the way back to Utkir Yusupov, born in Kazakhstan. Oh, Fazuliev. Offside as he went for the ball.
It's clever because he waited and waited for Rowles to have that touch first before going and closing down. And he did. He just caught him as well there. But he was in that offside position. And as that touch was being made, then he moved to an onside position and closed down.
Into the game, I think we were both expecting it to be cagey. Uzbekistan with that five-man back line.
My Don Woolley days, I never went to school either. Maths was never my strong point. Don Woolley, I called a lineup the other day, a 4-2-3. I forgot me striker.
There is Boyle. The point was making Uzbekistan a little bit more cautious. They had a four-man back line against India. That's an awkward one for Kianu Bakas. Erkinov just stepped out of the way. He knew Bakas was coming in. And actually made an inadvertent back for Bakas. This is the disallowed goal, Paul.
Yeah, you can clearly see offside again. You have the animation there to show that it was a very, very clear one on that occasion.
Yes, we've had a lot tighter. Tajikistan yesterday, two goals. The combined total of a toenail.
But if it's the correct decision, which it is, which is why it's been implemented to assist the game, then that's good. Just, I think it gets frustrating for the fans and the players sometimes when there's such a long wait on occasions for certain decisions. I think that's the frustrating thing with it, because technology will get faster and it is increasing the game and the quality of the game.
Abdullayev shows us an old-fashioned quality of the game, a big Hoyt clearance. Rolls, helped on. Shukarov, that's clever. Just couldn't carry it on.
That's a foul. And that could be trouble.
So a yellow card has been brought out for Umarbek Ashmuradov, Asaf centre-back.
Well, it's interesting because you watch the run, it's a great run. Is he offside? That's going to be the first question that gets asked. But he does bring him down there. Would he have got to the ball? There was another defender there, which probably could have come around and dealt with that situation as well. You see Graham Arnold here. He thinks that's a red, but I don't know, will suffice. But it is being checked, and it has been checked already. No red card.
Well, a no red card was the decision. That's what they are checking, whether that's accurate. He's going away from goal as well, it would be.
Correct. Well, we saw one overturned, didn't we, earlier in the competition, when the ball was played literally parallel to the goal, not forwards, and there was a defender that could have come back and dealt with it. The red card was shown and that got rescinded. So the question is, this is in reverse now. Is it because of this challenge a red card or not? The referee marching everyone back, so I think that's given us an indication that he's already had a word in his ear.
The check is still going on, Paul.
Yeah, but he's getting everybody back, he's getting everybody ready.
Suki Araki is the 37-year-old. He's only given out 22 yellows in his last seven matches. He likes to keep his cards in his pocket, from that evidence. Still, the check goes on. Now it's down. Riley McGree from the free kick lifts it up and almost into the air cooling ventilation behind the goal.
Yeah, just couldn't get it back down, could he? That was the problem.
Yellow card confirmed for Emashuradov. It's the first yellow card Uzbekistan have taken in the competition, which, should things go wrong for them and they come third, it could come into play.
It could do, but I doubt it. I think both sides here at the moment are looking comfortable. I think they'd be happy with where they are as well.
Shukarov beaten in the air. Referee, a little push on the ground as well by Bakas. And Shukarov doesn't like it. He's going for the ball. Says Keanu Bakas.
Just led with the arm, that's all, and the arm's come up over the top of Shukarov. That was where he caught him.
Again, maybe just a word coming in referee Araki's ears, and free kick now to be taken. Pinged out wide by Rustam Ashurmatov. Ashurmatov. Got to the semi-finals on one occasion, did Uzbekistan. The AFC Asian Cup, routinely make it through to the knockout stage as Jackson Irving goes over Shukarov.
Just cowered his back a little bit there, didn't he? Irving, eyes firmly fixed and focused on the ball. Shukarov just giving him a free ride, really, across his back.
I like that from Shukarov, offers the hand, and I like that from Irving. He's an impressive character, Jackson Irving. Riley McGree. That's better. Irving out wide to Atkinson. Atkinson helps it in. He doesn't beat the first man. Urunov. Saifiev goes outside of him. Urunov goes back towards his own goal. And then spins away. He's had a terrific game, Urunov. Shukarov, he can look right in the space for Abdurakhmatov. Three in the penalty area, should a cross come in. Abdurakhmatov for five, Zuliev. Who amongst the giants thought he should have got a better contact on the header. Good call from Ryan.
Comfortable and easy in the end. No problem, but good play. Particularly from Uzbekistan, switching it from left to right and carving open that Australian back line.
Started off with Urunov down on the left wing here. Australia, six goals since they conceded a goal, 18 months since they conceded a goal against an Asian team. Lovely run. Oh. Boss, and it's belted clear. Rolls has a job to do against Faizuliev and does it well, but what a good, strong attacking run.
I'm telling you, they have been working extremely hard defensively, Uzbekistan. You can clearly see it. That bank of five, then the four just in front. And it's going to take something like that. It's going to take a little mazy run. It's going to take a cute pass. It's going to take a fantastic dribble to get through this back line. Very, very well disciplined and very well organised this first half so far, Uzbekistan defensively.
Good header from Shukarov. Safeyev. Uranov wants it short again. Instead, he comes back to Ashurmatov. Abdurakhmatov hugging the far touchline. There he is on the ball. Little give and go, trying to involve Erkanov. Erkanov physically loses out to Jordi Boss. Good old-fashioned hockey hip check there from Jordi Boss.
A little bit more movement, a little bit more creativity from the Australian team. They're going to try and break down this Uzbek backline. They're going to need that. They are pushing up a little bit higher here, though. It's a very high line and a high press from Uzbekistan.
In the other game being played simultaneously in the group, it remains Syria 0, India 0. If Syria are going to nick second place, they need a hatful of goals against India and Uzbekistan to lose.
Actually hearing that it's quite a ferocious game. Very tough because both sides still with a possibility to go through as well, even India. We don't have a solitary point yet. If they were to win that on 3 points, they could possibly sneak into one of the best third place places that progress.
With China only securing 2 points for third place. Oh, the flag is up for offside against Erkanov. He came back from an offside position. Australia get on with it quickly. Bacchus, Atkinson. Safeyev is over very, very quickly.
He was lucky there because he let his man run. And Boyle had made a magnificent run across that back line to get in behind there. And it was being played onside. Tomasredov was just dropped in there. And if the ball was played through, Boyle would have been in.
Lost the target. Abdurakhmatov to Jackson Irvin. Tug on the shirt by Jackson Irvin, doesn't like it.
Well, he is all around him, all over him. Saw the hands going up. As soon as the hands go up, you know that you've had hold of him. Body language of players in game situations can tell you a lot.
A couple of hundred Uzbek fans, not sure whether they're expat or a few have taken flights over. Suter. Faizuliyev is 5'0".
I was up close with Suter the other day. I managed to interview before one of the games, and I can tell you, he's landed the Giants, 6'6", 6'7", a really big, strong, powerful lad. Good player as well, pretty solid.
His club team are riding high in the championship in England, though Suter hasn't had many games for them.
It's a big move for him, wasn't it?
The noise coming from the smattering of Uzbek fans in this wonderful stadium. Australia with great memories. This is where they beat Tunisia and Denmark in the World Cup just 15 months ago. Bacchus. Boss. To the organisation of Uzbekistan a few times, and it's clear for all to see on that picture. It was five. Ashurmatov then steps out and he intercepts, and there's a break on here from Ashurmatov. Lovely ball. Oh, it's the wrong option, Paul.
Correct. Absolutely the wrong ball. the right ball was Urunov on the left-hand side. There was a three-on-one situation there, and Australia again nearly shooting themselves in the foot. They can't find a way through these phases of games and through the passages of play. When they're playing the ball forwards, that press is coming in from Uzbekistan. They're winning it back, and bang, they're going very, very quickly. And there, they should have done a lot better when they got in behind that defence.
Shermatov coming out from the back five to make the interception.
They're not breaking the lines well enough, Australia. That's why I said earlier, where's the movement? Where's the movement? You're not making enough angles for your teammates. They just pass and pass and pass and pass. You're not going to get through that way. You've got to mix it up. Because, as I said, this Uzbek side has been very, very well disciplined and drilled so far.
Shukarov picks out Urunov. Atkinson back to defend. Three inside for Urunov. Final ball, not the best. Ryan McGree then gives the ball away to Urunov. Breaks to Shukarov. Hamrobakov, Erkinov, Hamrobakov, it might break out to Shukarov! What a block by Big Suter. Shukarov once again, Irvin clears. Now then, the powerful athletic Kuzina Yenge can drive forward, but runs into a knot of blue shirts. Couple of chances there for Shukarov.
Yeah, there was. Couple of good chances as well. But again, you know, the Aussies are going to throw themselves on the line and block anything that goes goal-bound as well. We've already mentioned their defensive prowess over the past, 18 months or so. The number of goals that they've conceded, very, very few. Even less and longer against Asian sides as well. So you've got to find a way to break them down. And they've gone close a couple of times here, Uzbekistan.
Well done, Kai Rolls. The heart centre-back, here's the work.
Well, this is where it's gone all wrong. McGree's turned back into himself, and he's going back to his own goal, and that caused all the problems and the furore. Then the ball bounces, it bobbles, it pops around, falls to Shukarov, and you just thought, could he have pulled the trigger quicker? Gets a second opportunity and couldn't get that one away.
Boyle tries to get through. Martin Boyle, just taken off him by Abduliev. Sorry, it's Ashmuradov, the centre of the three centre-backs. Just got a heel in the way.
Got away with that one, didn't they? Uzbekistan, first time that they've really looked dangerous getting in behind there, the Australians.
It's Martin Boyle, whose little bit of magic opened up Syria in the previous group game. Suter, goal-saving block from him. Hamrobakov, cool. And Robakov once again brings it out wide. Abderakhmatov is down at the moment, but Uzbekistan, the White Wolves, are on the prowl. Urunov cuts inside his man. Bakus. Abderakhmatov is now up once again, but feeling his ankle over the top end of the picture.
Just got caught, didn't he? Puff of the cheeks, though, tells you that he's going to be okay. Did he get caught? Yep. A little bit over the top there from Bacchus. A little bit naughty.
Suter sweeps one to the far side. Abderakhmatov did well. He's not the tallest, but he stood up to the physical challenge of Jordi Bos. Irvin wins the throw-in. Mwenge dispossessed. Mwenge once again. Oh, he's got to the byline, Mwenge. Still going, Mwenge pulls it back and pushed wide up. Mwenge did wonderfully well, Cousini Mwenge. Barged his way through, and that's a clear chance.
How's he missed it? That's what I want to know. How has he missed that? Mwenge does brilliantly here, look. Little nutmegs, gets to that byline, checks back. You think he was going to shoot, sees that vision and that pass to be able to pull it back. Puts it on an absolute plate. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. How has he missed that?
Riley McGree, he hasn't played much football, maybe. I'd say I need more practice, but no, he's 12 yards out, in front of goal, in the middle.
That's a chance. It's an absolute massive, massive chance.
And we're checking a possible penalty. There was a hint of a handball as Mwenge dinked and dived his way through.
We haven't really seen the players complain or moan too much about it. His arms, he's breaking a fall. Is it in an unnatural position? Not while he's falling down. I think it would be a soft one for me. I think it would be a little bit tough if it was given. Because if a player's falling down and you've checked back as a player and it just hits your arm, is that really you physically wanting to touch the ball with your arm? Not for me.
Again, they're having plenty of good looks. Yuzuki Araki has part of it being a team. He's just got to wait for what the VAR team say. Japanese and Chinese officials in the box, and once again it's one where there's a lengthy old delay.
He's sliding, he's trying to break that four, that's his arm. He's been asked to go and have a little look at this.
Well, normally that means that there's trouble for the defending team, but not always.
Yeah, we saw Mohamed Taki earlier on not give one. There it is. I mean, what are you supposed to do with your arm? He's sliding to try and put that challenge in. His arm's there just to break that four. It's how he got to that situation position. There. He hasn't stopped him going through with the ball. Look, he's still got the ball at his feet and still managed to conjure up that opportunity. So, for me, this would be a harsh one.
A few seconds before half-time, it's Odiljon Hamrobakov who's coming back, doing the work you want of your midfielders. I suppose he has committed himself.
He's got, yeah, but he's gone past him. Who's got the ball at his feet still? Mwenge. And he's still managed to conjure out that opportunity and chance. And it is the faintest and mightiest of touches. Let's see what the referee is going to decide here.
Oh, he's given a penalty. He's given a penalty. As soon as a referee is called over to the VAR box, and a yellow card as well. Gosh.
What? You're telling me that's a deliberate handball now? That's not a yellow card offence. That is not a yellow card offence.
It's the wordings of the laws for the officials.
That's harsh. In my opinion, it's harsh. I understand why it's been given. I do get it. But not for me.
So, VAR intervention. Sreko Katanek. Coaches and players, it's a different way to defend now. You just can't, if you are a defender, have your arms anywhere close to the ball.
So, you might as well say, if the ball touches your arm at any time, it's a handball, and it takes anything out of the game.
And
it makes it easier.
A yellow card as well, which seems doubly harsh.
That I'm a little bit bemused by, because it wasn't an intentional handball.
But Australia, as we come into time added on at the end of the first half, have the chance to take the lead. 7 minutes of time will be added on at the end of this first half. Yusupov, can he be a hero? No, he can't. Martin Boyle slides home coolly from the penalty spot, his seventh international goal. And harsh though it may be, Uzbekistan trail, Australia have the lead from the penalty spot, courtesy Martin Boyle.
Yeah, that experience was there for you to see, the way that he took that penalty, wasn't fazed by the amount of time that he had to wait. Coolly and calmly stepped up, just stroked it into that side netting. Has a glance to see the keeper on the way through. Says, OK, I'm going to stick this the other way. Good penalty, but a soft one, in my opinion.
So Australia on the way to what could be their first ever perfect group stage in the Asian Cup since they made their debut in 2007. Sheiko Katanec quite understandably looks aggrieved. He was an old-school centre-back in his day, and, well... But laws are laws, Paul.
Yeah, they are, and they're the rules, and they're there for a reason, and that's why we do have VAR here as well, is to enhance those rules and make sure that the decisions are right, and in the opinion of the officials, they've given the right decision.
Seven minutes of time to add on.
Shukarov's just gone in the book as well. I think having a little bit of a go at the referee there, Des, over that decision. That's a definite dissent booking.
Now, this becomes interesting. Should Syria score a couple of goals? Should Uzbekistan go a couple more down? Yellow cards could come into play in the countback in the race for P3. Three yellow cards now for Uzbekistan. In the midst of all that, Kuzini Yenge deserves immense credit for his original run. What a turn. Riley McGree. McGree denied by Hamrobakov.
Hamrobakov had to get that one absolutely spot on. It is a piece of brilliance. And that's what's been missing from this Australian team. Little things like that. McGree with a wonderful piece of skill here. Totally sells the defender. But then just couldn't get the ball across. But they do get the deflection, so they get themselves a corner.
Boyle, the goal scorer, to take it. Again, Suter, the obvious target, 6 yards out. It's over Suter and over the bar. But via a deflection, Jackson Irvin is sniffing around for his third goal of the tournament.
He's been lively today as well, hasn't he? He's been working incredibly hard. Just tracking in and attacking at that back post area.
Boyle again. Suter and Yenge pressuring the goalkeeper. Suter beaten to it by Yusupov. Boss. Hamrobakov, Erkinov. Free kick goes the way of Uzbekistan. Trying to break. Urunov. Blocked off by Bayich, who's done really well.
It'll be interesting now, though, to see if Uzbekistan will come out a little bit more in that second half to go after that equaliser.
At the moment, they don't need to, but it just becomes scary if Syria, who are capable of scoring goals.
You look at China and Group A yesterday, we had three teams at some stage in that game were in second place. Unbelievable, it really is, and you can't take the risk, so you have to come out, and they're going to have to open up a little bit more.
Just gone out of play from Riley McGree. Lovely turn by him just a few seconds ago. Bayich, another of those driving runs which he does so well. Bayich inside to Yenge. McGree. Boss thinks of the shot. Jordi Boss! just the 8 yards wide.
Yeah, plus plus. You'll see from this angle as well to conjure up and create that opportunity for himself. But I can guarantee you that's nowhere near the goal.
Good camera work, ball in the centre of the camera, right the way through.
He's 15 yards away from the goalpost.
He's a long final minute of time added on. Australia 1, Uzbekistan 0. A penalty scored by Martin Boyle in first half injury time. Dyrkinov. Shermatov. All the way back to Yusupov. It's away from Irvin. Nicely played by Hamrobikov. McGree loses out. Urunov drives forward. Urunov. Erkinov, no free kick. Australia come away with the ball. Uzbekistan officials are not happy with that non-decision, but Riley McGree carries on. Little give and go. McGree is then taken out. Yenge. Bejic. And Boss. Yenge. That's a good header just over the top.
I think we might see some fireworks here in the second half, Desmond. I really, really do, because I'm telling you, there's getting a bit of niggle and needle here. There really, really is. They were incensed when that free kick wasn't given. But then the Aussies went forward and had that opportunity to double the advantage.
That was the team manager coming out irate, and those eyes have not calmed down just yet.
Got to keep your discipline. Even on the bench, you have to keep a certain decor and decorum. You have to, because at the end of the day, that reflects on your players.
Irvin's done well. McGree tries to get through. Yusupov out to the edge of his penalty area. We're a minute into the time added on. Matty Ryan plays centre back.
Sweeper keeper, as John Beck used to say.
Half-time whistle goes, blown by Yusiki Araki. Australia have the lead, courtesy Martin Boyle. A penalty that was VAR assisted. Sheiko Katanec is still trying to gather his thoughts, but it's Martin Boyle's penalty that has separates the teams after a very tight and cagey first half in which Australia had more of the ball. But Uzbekistan looked good on the breakaway. This game, Paul Masefield, isn't over yet.
No, it isn't, and what's happened there with that goal being awarded, and there's one or two decisions here. I think that you'll see Uzbekistan come out very, very physically at the start of the second 45. They've got to keep their discipline, though. They've got to keep their cool. The manager's already marching over to the referees to go and have a chat with them. The team manager, that is. So everybody not happy at the moment in the Uzbek camp, which means they could lose their heads. They've got to keep their cool. The Aussies, though, with the balance of play, the way that they've played, probably just deserve to be a smidgen ahead.
Half-time at the Al Wakra, at the Al Janoub in Al Wakra in Qatar. It's Australia 1, Uzbekistan 0.
Go, 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 go
Very warm welcome back to the Al Janoub Stadium in the Al Wakra region of Qatar. We're about 25 kilometres south of the landmark Corniche. It's third match of the groups. Australia leading Uzbekistan by 1-0. Uzbekistan out quickly and making a change. Jalidin Masharipov from the Greek club Panathinaikos coming on for his 58th international appearance. Australia still to make their way out onto the pitch. The only goal of the game, a contentious VAR-affected penalty. The change, Oston Urunov, who had a very good First 20 minutes at least, took Nat Atkinson to the cleaners a couple of times. Atkinson recovering to play pretty well after that. Australia beginning to make their way out onto the pitch. Martin Boyle scoring the penalty on first half injury time. As Australia make their way out, Australia looking to secure 3 wins out of 3 in the group stage of the AFC Asian Cup for the first time in their history. Sreko Katanec having to calm down during the half-time break. Second half about to get underway. Blue shirts of Uzbekistan going left to right, get us underway. Second half of this final match of the group. The one change from them, Masharipov is on for Urunov. Australia, the same 11 who guided Australia into a first-half lead. Contentious though it was, the penalty. Paul Masefield in the commentary box alongside Des Corkill. And Paul, the half-time talk is still all about the penalty. Technically correct because it has brushed the arm, but very, very tough to take. Just break off for a moment. Because Boyle is chasing down. Oh, and it's blocked. A big chance coming in from Riley McGree. Boss, Bejic, second chance to play it in. Physicality there, and there's a clash of heads. Riley McGree and Ham Robakov. Here's the chance that was created, though. Really good play by Jordy Boss.
Couldn't put his foot in, though, could he? Didn't want to concede the penalty. Boss driving all the way through there and just trying to conjure something up and make something happen. Then there's this challenge. Knew exactly what he was doing there. And Robakov was never going to win the ball. Did catch the man instead, so it's a free kick in what could be a relatively dangerous area.
As we wait for the ball to get back, final thoughts on the penalty until we bring it up next.
Yeah, it was, in my opinion, it was a soft one, but like you've said, letter of the law. We have VAR for a reason. It's there to be used, and the decision was made.
Free kick now. Boyle over the ball, Boss to his left. McGree might just reach this one over to Harry Suter, who always comes into the conversation when there's free kicks around this area. Boyle lifts it in. It's over Suter. Ashurmatov, good clearance. Erkanov onto Masharipov. Under real pressure. McGree's done well. And so, to be fair, did Masharipov.
This is where Uzbekistan have to keep their concentration, have to keep their focus. I'm sure there was some words said at half-time and a lot of frustration in that dressing room. Graham Arnold's far too experienced to allow that to affect his team, which is why his team talk would have just been keep it simple, keep your cool, keep calm, let them get all flustered.
Australia's lineup, they've got Ryan in goal. Suter plays that in, looks for Bejic. Matt Ryan in goal, the back four, Nathaniel Atkinson, Harry Suter, Kai Rolls, and as is Bejic. Jackson Irvine, Keanu Bakas, and Riley McGree, the midfield three. McGree getting forward a lot. Martin Boyle, the scorer. Jordy Boss and Kuzini Yenge, the front three. Uzbekistan, Yusupov in goal, Abdullayev, Eshmuradov, who's on a yellow card, and Ashurmatov along the back. Abdirakhmatov, Hamrebekov, Shukarov, and Saifayev along midfield, Erkanov, Faizuliev, and now Masharipov as the front three. Shukarov with the header. Rose. A little bit of head tennis that goes the way of Australia.
Not happy again. Kanate saying that there was a little shove in the back. Not given. He really, really isn't happy today, is he?
That was a big smile, just you were looking at him, away from him, and he had a big smile.
He's still not happy.
Not disagreeing.
Just because you're smiling.
Faizuliev does well. Can he play it out wide? He can, but not quickly enough. There's a free kick right on the edge of the penalty area and a yellow card. Faizuliev, is it Bakas who left a foot in?
Somebody left the foot in. It was a big foot as well.
Harry Suter.
Suter. Boom. There you go. Right over the top of the ball. Did catch him. Got to the ball first. Fazulayev to just nip it past Suter. And Suter just overstretching. Just couldn't get there. Got the man instead. Dangerous, dangerous position here. Well, I did like someone like, you remember, Serverjeparov, how you'd like him on this free kick here if you're an Uzbekistan fan. What a player he was for the national team.
Roll back those years, imagine.
It'd only go one place. It'd go the top corner, 100%. That's how good he was.
However, there is no Djeparov, but there is Masharipov. Got 11 international goals to his name.
Kindred spirits.
Masharipov is 10. And Masharipov just wide. Ryan is scrambling for that.
That is not a million miles away, let me tell you. Good technique. Just couldn't bring it back that little bit more that it needed. But there it goes, just a couple of inches wide of that post. Not sure Ryan would have got that had it just been inside the post.
Ferocious power from Masharipov. As Ryan plays it out, Atkinson. Australia 6.5 games now without conceding a goal. The 1-0 defeat against England, the last goal they did concede. And he's not shy to take on big opponents, is Graham Arnold. Argentina, amongst the teams who have been played since the last World Cup, and England. Test yourself against some of the best in the world.
Well, that's how you gauge yourself. That's where you know where you are in the pecking order, but it also gives you invaluable experience.
It is a much-changed lineup from the one that played in the World Cup just 15 months ago. Shmurdov with the header. Vasiliev just dispossessed by Bejic. Irvin, little give and go from Irvin, just tried to slide it in. Boss always wants to go on his left side, Jody Boss. Ashurmatov. Sharipov given a lot of license to roam. Saifeyev.
Australia happy to allow Uzbekistan to have the ball in front of them. That's what they've got to be wary of.
Masharipov. Is that a goal kick or a free kick against Masharipov? Bakos has done well to track back.
He has, but they just got in behind them there, didn't they? Uzbekistan then came back out as well. I think it's a free kick that has been awarded.
Simultaneous group matches going on match day 3. Just to make sure there's no chance of anyone doing anything untoward. It's still Syria 0, India 0. As it stands, Australia 9 points, top of the group. Uzbekistan 4. Yenge's done well. Boss couldn't take it in his stride. Masharipov helps it out to Saifeyev. Lovely give and go. Masharipov faced by two in green and gold. Atkinson did well. Suter was the big covering player. Australia have now got everybody back. Abdurakhmatov.
Question is they've got to release and let somebody else push forwards here, Uzbekistan, because Australia are getting bodies behind the ball. There's two or three blue shirts, as you can see just on your screen there on the left-hand side, that could be deployed to move a little bit further forwards to cause an issue or problem.
Erkinov the target. Erkinov's done really well to get ahead of Bejic. Oh, well played, Jackson Irvin. Erkinov wins it back from Bejic. Great covering there from Irvin. Shukarov. Suter puts that 6'7" frame in the way.
wanted it earlier. Great running behind that was.
It's a good spell for Uzbekistan. The White Wolves chasing an equaliser.
Yeah, but this is what I'm saying, Des. Where are they going? Everything's in front. So the Aussies are defending and keeping their shape very, very well. The time they've got to worry is when they do get behind them. The Australians need to be concerned.
Abdullah Abdullayev plays his football in Khorfa Khan, just in the United Arab Emirates. Yusupov. Boss couldn't keep it alive. Shermatov. Sharipov. Yenge doing some hard yards. Those little 5 meter sprints, they are soul destroying. Shatiu, he's worked hard, Yenge. Had the ball in the back of the net early on in the game, but Martin Boyle being offside. Sharipov slides it through to Hamrobakov. Sharipov again. No room through. Backer sticks out a leg. That's not the best clearance from Atkinson. Clever. Saifayev. But when a cross comes in like that, you'd expect Australia to clear. They don't. Doratimov gets the shot away. Summing up your point earlier, how do Uzbekistan break Australia down?
They've got to get in behind them. They've got the width and they've got the ability, and that's there. I mean, that's brilliant play.
Erkanov pass Bejic. Rolls does well. Boss. McGree spreads it out to Boyle.
Watch out for this Uzbekistan side in the knockouts. I'm telling you. If they can play like this, it's only one little mistake that they've made that has cost them here. They're very, very well drilled, well organised outfit. You have a look at the way that they control the ball, the way they pass the ball, the touch, the running off the ball, the work they do for each other. This is a very good Uzbek side, so it's telling me as well that the Australian side is very good as well and solid in certain areas. They just need a little bit more going forwards in that final third for me, Australia. Could say the same about Uzbekistan. Haven't really over-created chances in this game so far.
I think the Uzbek team and Katanec, they were worried about where the goals were going to come from. And you can't float the ball up like that to Faziev. Bakus dragged back by Shukarov. Referee said no. Atkinson loses a 50-50 with Hamrobakov. Sharipov, Saifiev goes outside of him. Sharipov looks for the wall pass and is blocked off. Free kick Uzbekistan.
Getting closer, aren't they, to trying to create something. Bakus just having to react there and bringing him down. They are keeping the ball much better this second 45 minutes.
Somehow from these set plays, you've got to keep Suter out of the equation. Sharipov does exactly that, the equaliser! Shumaradov, but the flag is up for offside. He thinks they've got it.
Well, you wouldn't have thought that the Australians would have been done in the air from a corner.
Shumaradov, 15 in the middle of your screen. It does look like it's a good call by the assistant referee.
Oh, let's see if they're going to run the line with him. or the other players as well. That's what they'll be checking for here. He is very, very close. And I mean, it's a very close margin. There are players in and around that were a little bit more advanced. And that is why this is going to be checked, and checked thoroughly by the looks of things here. Was he offside? That's the question.
Harry Suter it is, who's the back man for Australia. To the naked eye, it looked the correct call. But the naked eye didn't look like a penalty either, did it? Right, the check is over. Esmuradov.
Was just offside.
Yenge will chase.
He's worked hard today, hasn't he, Yenge? Like to see him with a little bit more in and around him as well. One or two players that he can link up with. That would look good.
Irvin. Yenge. Abdullayev very, very close. Couple of changes being planned. This is as Togunboyev from Paktakor. Another pacey little winger. Suter takes away from Fayzuliev. Sheremetov wanted that first. Fayzuliev, great tackle. Had to get there, Atkinson.
Yeah, it was a good tackle.
Does well. I think we're going to get the answer to your poser of whether or not Uzbekistan are going to go for it with who is replaced by Sergeyev. Here's the offside once again, Paul. Oh, it's a shoulder. It's a shoulder.
I told you that one was close. I told you that was close. But again, it's there for a reason. It's been used. It's been used to effect as well.
That's been shown in the big screen in the arena as well, how close it was. So Fayzuliev and Erkinev off. Good performances from both. Turgunbayev, he comes on. And a more muscular challenge from Igor Sergeyev, the BG Patam United centre-forward.
Chengi thought he got away with that one. Uzbekistan getting on with things very, very quickly.
So it's the front three for Uzbekistan that have changed. It's slightly more physical. It's Australia who have the lead. Well played by Atkinson. Sheremetov looks for Sergeyev. There is still a place in modern football for old-fashioned centre-forwards, isn't there, Paul?
Always.
Big fellas.
Yeah, always. Just got to get the ball into them. They're obviously going to be a lot more mobile than they were back in the day as well. Nothing wrong with getting the ball forwards. It's what you do when it gets there.
Jody Boss, decent ball, well mopped up on the far post, expertly mopped up by Sergeyev. First involvement for Turgunbayev. Easy for Harry Suter. Bacchus, he's been neat and tidy, Keanu Bacchus.
Yeah, just sat in there and done a job, hasn't he?
Nobody's really talking Australia up, are they? That could make them dangerous because they're difficult to break down. has potentially going a long way in this tournament. Irvin, Boss. Bejic stands it up to Yenge. Somehow saved on the goal line. That's remarkable by Ashmuradov.
There's a push. That's why there you can clearly see Yenge. Big shove at the far post. Referee blew the whistle straight away.
Excellent defended by Ashmuradov anyway. Andrei Rakhmatov. As we approach the midway point of this second half, Uzbek fans trying to encourage their team to nick the equaliser. It remains Syria 0, India 0 in the other match in the group.
Could still have a bearing, that's why they've got to get themselves a goal if they can here, Uzbekistan.
Neat and tidy. Bakos. Bejic. Suter. Great movement by Bejic going forward.
That was what they needed in the first half to get through and break that defence. Bejic getting in there, Atkinson pushing on as well. They're doing it more this second half, to be fair.
Across to Suter. Irvin. Shermatov. Saifayev. Masharipov. Who's looked livelier today than in any of the previous matches in which Uzbekistan have played. I'm sure Australia will be quite pleased to see Masharipov picking the ball that deep.
But they're keeping their shape and they're doing their job as well.
Not a great ball by Abdulyev. Easy possession for Bejic.
No, that was poor.
Australia 1, Uzbekistan 0. Australia beating India 2-0 on match day 1. Stubborn India side. A stubborn Syrian side beaten 1-0 on match day 2. Lovely run. Atkinson's gone a long way. Bejic, two fullbacks. And Boyle. Shukurov slides in. McGree. Still Riley McGree. Was I thinking the right? Oh, Riley McGree's left a foot in there. A yellow card, and with all of these things you wonder what the replay will look like, Paul.
Yeah, you do. Just grabbed him then. Oh, come straight round the back of him as well.
That's a really strange attack. He's, okay, he's trying to get it with the bottom right foot and the left foot comes around the back. Yellow card for Riley McGree.
They're going to make a change as well now, Australia.
Well, the thinking was Riley McGree would maybe have a 60 minutes. He's been on, what are we, close to 70?
Looks like Metcalf getting ready to come on as well.
And Sharipov again. Ryan. Shooter. As it stands, this score would suit both teams. Sharipov, he's back by Atkinson. Suter's header. That's off the hand. Chagunbayev beaten to the punch. I like these driving runs from Bajic when he's got forward just a little bit behind Kuzina Yenge. Martin Boyle, the goal scorer, is the man to be replaced by Metcalf. Conor Metcalf, the São Paulo midfielder, coming on for his 17th international cap.
Yeah, just to freshen it up, put some fresh legs out there. That's the key thing for them. But to be fair, they've managed to get themselves that foothold in the game a little better. Because Uzbekistan, about 15 minutes, passed the ball around and looked very, very good, but Australia have done well to hold on to things and get themselves right back into this and could sneak another one.
Bacchus puts it out wide to Atkinson. Boss had made a run in front of him. Atkinson comes back. Possessional. Very important. Saifeyev was very aware that Atkinson was closing in on him there. Didn't want to put his head onto that. The ball from Utke Yusupov goes straight out of play. It's the fifth match in which Australia and Uzbekistan have played. Uzbekistan have yet to score in those five. The most recent game was a penalty shootout 0-0 draw that Australia won in 2019. Well played by Turgunbayev. Shukarov, Masharipov just dilly-dallied a little bit too long. Yenge held it up well. Jackson and Yenge.
Good play from Yenge there. Just needs someone in and around him, I feel. If he's got someone who's in and around him, he could cause a lot of problems.
Socceroos happy to hold on to the ball. Here's Kai Rolls. I can tell you there is a goal in the other match. As Ashmuradov comes over to sweep up, and it has gone to Syria. Syria 1. India 0. That puts them on 4 points, the same as Uzbekistan. The goal difference, because in the head-to-head they were a goalless draw, the goal difference is still in favour of Uzbekistan. Should Uzbekistan concede a second and Syria score a second, then it gets nervy for Uzbekistan.
Certainly does. Really, really, really does. Very, very interesting indeed. Uzbekistan don't look out of this game. It's not like it's chalk and cheese, is it? They've turned around, they've been not bad at all. Australia just nicking that goal.
official attendance, just over 15,000 here. It's about a third full, a wonderful, wonderful venue. And these pictures are just glorious. Get on with it, he's saying, get on with it. As is Bajic. Trying to back us, barged over by Shukarov. Jackson Irving. Good strong play by Boss. And again, has been effective down this left-hand side, certainly defensively. Atkinson. Been rather forced out of the full-back position. Gethin Jones seems to be the favoured right-back for Atkinson. After many permutations from Graham Arnold in solving that right-back slot. Ryan's a long ball, picked off by Eshmuradov. The group winners here, they play the team who comes third in either group A, C or D.
Could be anyone when you turn around and look at it like that. The only thing is that China, with only 2 points, doesn't look as though they'll get in. I think 3 points is enough, possibly, this edition. 4 will get you in.
And that's what Syria have got at the moment.
Still, of course, a lot of games to play. The groups will be finished by the end of this week. And a little break before the round of 16.
Masharipov. Lovely ball into the back post. Glorious, glorious chip. And the goal from Turbombayev.
It's been coming. You can't say it hasn't. But I can't believe that the Aussies have been beaten in the air from a ball that's been whipped in from a wide area. Lovely, lovely finish. It really was. Just had to be in the right place at the right time. He got up extremely well and made absolutely no mistake. That should be enough to see them all the way through. Great work again in those wide areas. We said getting in behind, and they do. He's just hung that up. He's got to turn around. Bajic does not know that he's there. He just comes, raises up over the back of him. So Gomboyev makes absolutely no mistake with a textbook finish. And that's what you want from your wingers when they're playing, to come in and close that back door. It's a good, good goal. And it's a first goal conceded from Australia in a long, long time.
Third international goal for Azizbek Turgunboyev. Made by Masharipov. They got round the back a couple of times in the first half, Paul, and you were saying that the pullback needed to be lifted to the far post. Clearly, they listened to you at half-time.
When you get to the byline, you can't put it into that near-post area. You've got to hang it up at the far post.
Bajic beaten by the jump. And Uzbekistan, well played, have got themselves all square. Now, do they go and try and win it and win the group? Suter clears. Saifayev. Australia's proud record of six clean sheets in a row is broken by a far post header made by Masharipov, who's on the ball once again. Safeyev.
They look more likely though, don't they?
There was a sense Australia were almost settling for the 1-0. Masharipov once again teases Bacchus. Invites McGree to come and challenge. Igor Sergeyev, heavy first touch. Boss has Sergeyev in pursuit. Sergeyev hurt himself. Keep an eye on Igor Sergeyev. Yeah, Igor Sergeyev landed very awkwardly as he chased Yuri Boss there. Immediately he's gone down. There's no histrionics here. I'm worried about this.
No, that's a muscle that's gone. That's either his hamstring or his calf. It's not his knee. He went down to clutch his calf, so he may have just pulled or torn a calf or hamstring muscle there. That looks like a muscular injury. Doubt he'll be able to carry on.
They're already short of resources for main strikers. And Sergeyev, I think, was just trying to make an impact. He had a loose touch and was chasing back to try and make amends. Here's the goal once again. Masharipov does brilliantly.
Brilliant. Love it. Absolutely love it. That is a quality finish, let me tell you, because that's what you want from your wingers. They've got to close that back door. So Gumboev just went and attacked it. And because he's got that running onto the ball, he can get a higher leap above Behic, who didn't know he was there. He was closed off, which meant he was caught ball watching and didn't realise that Tugumboev was going to come in round over the top of him. That's exactly what he did.
Changes meanwhile for Australia. Aidan O'Neill, the standard Liège midfielder, comes on for his 11th cap. Bruno Fornaroli was also on for his 5th. Well, victory strikers in really good form domestically. Sympathies for Igor Sergeyev, and an immediate replacement for the substitute, Jamshid Iskandarov, a very different kind of player. The Napahor attacking midfielder will come on for his 33rd international appearance, but Igor Sergeyev is carried off by the medical team. And immediately, Paul, that looked like a bad one for Sergeyev.
Yeah, it's a muscle injury, so he's out the tournament. I'll be amazed if he does come back and play any more game time. Neither be a tear or a strain or a pull, but the way that he pulled up, we've all torn our hamstrings and torn our calves, and they can be very, very painful. You can't play on.
So Iskandarov on for Sergeyev. Fornaroli's first involvement. Atkinson, O'Neill, who's a neat and tidy midfielder. Bajic, over the top. Wants Fornaroli to chase that one. The other match in the group remains Syria 1, India 0. Approaching the final few minutes there, we're approaching the 85th minute here. Umar Khibin with the goal for Syria. National icon Umar Khibin. Yangi. wrestled away from the ball. That takes some doing with Cassini Yenge.
Everybody just needs to calm down a little bit here. I think that's what's happening. Everybody's just shouting at each other. Calm down again. Uzbekistan have gone back to those banks, and Australia looking to work the lines in between the lines again.
Boss.
Pretty much a pattern of the first half.
Both teams definitely through as first and second in the group if it's 1-1. Uzbekistan. Now they'd love to top a group for the very first time. Bayich, too much on that. How do you think the respective pressers will regard these this performance, certainly from Australia first and foremost, Paul?
Australia, I think they'll be saying that they've been in control of the match, which they have, to be fair. It's been a pretty even timing. Let's be honest, these are two heavyweights of Asian football coming together. They are two of the bigger nations. It's never going to be easy playing against Uzbekistan. But I think that they'll be just worried about where the goals are going to come from. I think probably both sets of press and both sets of media will be like that. But I do think that we've got two very strong, solid units out there that could go deep into this competition.
Has Yenge done enough to be the permanent replacement for Mitch Duke? Has break off just for a moment. Fornaroli does really well. Boss pulls it back, looks for Yenge, head to the box. Up and over the top. Conor Metcalf. Lovely little work from Fornaroli. He's not a long-term answer for Graham Arnold, but he could well have a significant role to play in this Asian Cup.
Everyone does.
Six green and gold, looking to pinch the win for Australia.
Is there going to be late drama here? That's the big question, because it would be very, very dramatic.
Metcalf's corner. Well met by Masharipov on the near post. Iskandarov can't get the better of Atkinson. A lot of teams have tried to crowd the goalkeeper throughout this tournament. But the delivery into that near post, if you really whip it in, low and flat, it can be very difficult to defend. But teams generally have defended it pretty well.
Oh dear. That's a little bit of an injury for Atkinson as well. He's had a bit of calf and a bit of cramp. Yeah, that's just a touch of cramp.
Masharipov doing the sporting thing.
No corners for Uzbekistan so far today. Tells you that, again, the Australian defence has been solid to an extent, only breached that once.
Bayic. Abdullayev does well. And he finds Boss. Boss barges his way through. Abdullayev Rakhmatov has shown real composure for one so young. The wing back, just 20 years of age. Metcalf tries to play it in. That's clever from Fornaroli. The flag is up for offside earlier on in the move.
Yeah. They do like to try and delay it a little bit now to see if play goes on and just to get the reassurances whilst the third team, as we call them, all the officials communicate with each other.
7 minutes to add on.
This is a first. in this tournament, the same number of minutes added on at the beginning, at the end of the first half, and the same number of minutes added on at the end of the second half.
104-minute games now. Mashadapov, Iskandarov, Mashadapov cuts inside. Togunbayev, the goal scorer, he's taking the main striker role now with Sergeyev off the pitch. Whoop. Scary moment there for Yusupov. Hoists it long, and that's easy for Suter.
Yeah, I think both sides would be happy with this now. Guaranteed to go through anyway, quite literally with the number of points they'd already amassed. You know, that they're both going to be fighting and in contention going into that round of 16. It was just who was going to finish where. Would have offered them both a draw before the game. I think they're probably both obtaining it as well.
Bajic. And they can just sit back, worry about who they're going to get in the round of 16. Then the competition starts for real.
Game on. Coming soon.
Two more matches tonight, local time, 6 p.m. New channels around the region. I hope you're enjoying our coverage of the 2023 AFC Asian Cup. That's the proper name for it, even though we are into the new year. Qatar has put on a pretty good show so far. Australia ease their way through already into the round of 16. Uzbekistan a couple of minutes away from joining them as Bajic. Final couple of changes for Australia. Jordan Boss needs to be replaced. Marco Tilio comes on, the Celtic player, for his ninth appearance. And Matt Atkinson to be replaced at right back by Lewis Miller from Hibs. Hibs being Hibernian in Scotland.
It'll be a little bit of late drama.
Iskandarov does just enough there, lifts it up into the body of Jackson Irving. That long throw had one or two problems for Uzbekistan defensively.
Yeah, they went and won the ball though, didn't they? They were strong. Plenty for both teams to take out of this game though. There really is positives more than negatives, I would say. The negative thing is probably both sides in that final third just need that little bit of cutting edge, that little bit more creativity. Because defensively, we've seen two good sides today.
The injuries as well to Sergeyev and Mitch Duke, who is probably out for the round of 16. With hamstrings, you worry, but they'll be even longer than you fear. Mashadapov, great little 45-minute cameo from Mashadapov. Set up the goal, has looked to be the leader, took the captain's armband. Long-range effort just over the top. Conor Metcalf coming down on the half volley. Needed to catch it just a little bit lower. Yusupov was behind that all the way.
Yeah, just need to get over the ball just a little bit more. That won't stop till the final whistle, though, that's for sure.
Australia's winning run likely to come to an end. Australia's clean sheet run has come to an end. Nonetheless, progression through to the round of 16 and the knockout stage is what the most important thing was for the Socceroos.
Well, we've guaranteed two more going in there. There'll be two more a little bit later. So by the end of the day, there's a minimum of six that'll be guaranteed. And you would have thought, with the way that it is in the India game, with 4 points, we've actually got another one that we can add in there.
Syria, and they will be a problem for whoever they take on. They gave Australia plenty of worries on match day two. Suter onto Yenge. Tilio, lovely cross! Don't you love an old-fashioned winger? Tilio again. Mazy little dribble. And Rebikov. Good upper body strength.
Yeah, it was pretty solid. Lovely footwork, though, wasn't it? Just jinks in between the two of them there, and then just shoulder-to-shoulder more than anything.
Final score from the other match. Syria have indeed beaten India by a goal to nil. So unless Uzbekistan concede four goals in the next 2 seconds, Uzbekistan are through, Paul.
Uzbekistan are through, we know that. And I tell you what, on 4 points, because of the ways that the groups are, you would hazard a guess that Syria are going to go through as well. But that will be confirmed at a later date. But they've put themselves in a great, great position to do so. But a good game today with these two.
It's finished here at the Aljanoub Stadium. Australia 1, Uzbekistan 1. Turgunbayev's 78th minute equaliser. Deserved for Uzbekistan, who'd gone behind to Martin Boyle's controversial penalty at the end of the first half. Honours shared. Fifth time the teams have met. Second time it has been all square. Second time in the Asian Cup. Uzbekistan will go through as second team in the group. Australia will be group winners, which is something they don't often achieve in the Asian Cup, and theoretically it gives you a slightly easier route towards the latter stages. Uzbekistan suffering an injury to Igor Sergeyev late on in the game. That will really hurt their already sparse attacking resources, but they've got themselves a deserved point here. Turgunbayev's excellent goal after some brilliant individual play from Asharipov providing the equaliser. Both teams had a goal disallowed. It was a well-contested game played in a good spirit, though there were five yellow cards handed out. But it's finished here at the Aljanoub Stadium in Al Wakra of Australia 1, Uzbekistan 1.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a...